Listen, everybody, to the words I have to say. Better get ready, because the Lord is coming one day. This is Daniel White III with a special report from Second Coming Watch update. This is update 328. This week is a vacation week for me. However, I thought I would come in and share this bit of news with you. Let's take a quick look at today's prophecy-related headlines, which point towards the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ and the end of the world as we know it. First up today, according to Agence France-Presse, as well as USA Today, the North Korean army said on Thursday that it had final approval to launch merciless military strikes on the United States, involving the possible use of cutting-edge nuclear weapons. In a statement published by the official KCNA news agency, the General Staff of the Korean People's Army said it was formally informing Washington that reckless U.S. threats would be smashed by cutting-edge smaller, lighter, and diversified nuclear strike means. In fact, this just in, missiles have been positioned for a strike against U.S. allies and or the U.S. Second, today, according to the Associated Press, at least 52 people drowned in their homes and cars were electrocuted or died in other accidents as flooding from days of torrential rains swamped Argentina's low-lying capital and province of Buenos Aires. At least 46 died Wednesday in and around the city of La Plata. Many people climbed onto their roofs in the pouring rain after storm sewers backed up. Water surged up through drains in their kitchen and bathroom floors and then poured in over their windowsills. Governor Daniel Scioli said such intense rain in so little time has left many people trapped in their cars, in the streets, in some cases electrocuted. We are giving priority to rescuing people who have been stuck in trees or on the roofs of their homes. He added that he has never seen anything equal to this disaster. Third, today, according to the Associated Press, the United Nations General Assembly overwhelmingly approved the first UN treaty regulating the multi-billion-dollar international arms trade, a goal sought for over a decade to try to keep illicit weapons out of the hands of terrorists, insurgent fighters, and organized crime. The resolution adopting the landmark treaty was approved by a vote of 154-3 with 23 abstentions. British Foreign Secretary William Hague said the world wanted this treaty and would not be thwarted by the few who sought to prevent the introduction of robust, effective, and legally binding controls on the international trade in weapons. Fourth, according to DEPCA file, incoming intelligence that Al-Qaeda groups in the Sinai Peninsula are preparing for an attack on an Israeli location, such as the southern city of Eilat, and a U.S. military target in the Negev has put southern Israeli and U.S. forces posted there on high terror alert. The Israeli High Command is treating the five rockets fired into southern Israel by an Al-Qaeda-affiliated group as the opening salvo of a coordinated attack. An Iron Dome battery was accordingly moved to the Israeli-Egyptian border, and additional IDF military resources were directed to the south. 5th today, according to the Associated Press. Health officials say they still don't understand how a lesser-known bird flu virus was able to kill 4 men and seriously sicken 7 others in China, but that it is unlikely that the virus can spread easily among humans. 2 men in Shanghai became the first known human fatalities from the H7N9 bird flu virus after contracting it in February. A woman who was infected remains in serious condition. It was unclear how the patients became infected, and China's health ministry is attempting to calm fears about the potential for the virus spreading. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, verses 3 and 4, knowing this first, that there shall come in the last days scoffers walking after their own lusts, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. You can read these stories in more detail and get more prophecy-related news at SecondComingHerald.com.
We trust that this broadcast/podcast is being a blessing and encouragement to you, in reminding you of the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, and in keeping you informed about prophecy-related events in the news. Our host, Daniel White III, has an ebook titled, 10 Things God Wants You to Do in the Last Days. This book gives 10 biblical tasks that all of us should be engaged in as we await Christ's return. You can purchase the ebook online for just $1.99 at SecondComingHerald.com. Your purchase of this book will help us continue to spread this message around the world for the glory of God. Now, here's Daniel White III with a closing word.
If you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, may I encourage you to get to know Him today. To do so, please understand with me that you are a sinner, and so am I, and that you have broken God's laws at some point in your life. However, in spite of your sins, God still loves you, and He does not want you to be separated from Him forever. Romans 5:8 tells us that God commendeth His love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Because Jesus Christ died for your sins, all you have to do is believe in Him and receive His free gift of salvation. If you do so, you will not have to suffer eternal punishment in hell, but you will live eternally in heaven with God. Now, dear friend, if you believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins, was buried and rose again, and you want to invite Him into your heart today, please pray with me this simple prayer and mean it from your heart. Holy Father God, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad things in my life. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of my sins. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died for me, was buried, and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today. Amen. Dear friend, if you just trusted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and you prayed that prayer and you meant it from your heart, I declare to you that based upon the Word of God, you are now saved and you are on your way to heaven. Welcome to the family of God. I want to congratulate you on receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. For more information to help you grow in your new faith in Christ, go to GospelLightSociety.com and read what to do after you enter through the door. Jesus Christ said in John 10:9, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. Now in closing, please remember the words of the Lord Jesus Christ in Matthew 24:42. Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doeth come. Matthew 24:44 says, therefore be ye also ready, for in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh. Now let us join in the prayer of John the Revelator when he prayed, even so come, Lord Jesus, even so come, Lord Jesus. God bless you.